We have been fortunate to have a highly effective and a very safe vaccine for adults and adolescents for the last several months. And now these data show that we also now have a very safe and effective vaccine for children 5 to 11 years of age. And so I find that very reassuring. It's another step in the right direction for equipping physicians to be able to provide protection to children in order to move forward and get us out of this pandemic. The vaccine effectiveness was about 91%. That means the risk of developing COVID-19 after exposure is substantially less compared to those who are not vaccinated. If we compare antibody responses in adolescents and young adults, children 5 to 11 years of age who get that lower dose, their antibody levels are just as strong. And so that allows us to use a dose that's about 70% lower in children age 5 to 11 than has been used in adolescents and young adults. Presumably, that would mean fewer side effects. People point out accurately that the rate of severe complications and death in children is much lower than adults. That's correct. But we know that children are not free from the harmful effects of this virus. Widespread community transmission is primarily the reason why schools aren't back to normal, why many sports don't look like what they looked like before the pandemic. Children we know can transmit this virus to other people in the community that are more vulnerable. Vaccinating children will be really important for us to be able to return to normal life as we know it and to continue to protect everybody in our communities. It would be unlikely that we would consider any child fully vaccinated by Thanksgiving because it's a two-dose regimen given 3 weeks apart, and then you would be considered fully vaccinated 2 weeks after that dose. And so you won't be fully vaccinated until at least 5 weeks after your vaccine. Families that seek their first shot by mid-November, that those children will be considered fully vaccinated by the winter holidays at the end of December.